class, I'm Dr. Priyarishna, professor at HOD EC department. Today I'm going to tell about the internal RAM memory of the 8051. External RAM memory. Memory of the 8051. So 8051 is having internal RAM memory and internal RAM memory. Internal RAM memory is 128 bytes. Internal RAM memory is 4 kilobytes. Internal RAM memory is 128 bytes. Internal RAM memory is 4 kilobytes. So here bytes only, here kilobytes. Okay. So the maximum memory that we can extend for RAM memory and RAM memory is 64 kilobytes of memory. We can extend up to 64 kilobytes of memory. Okay. So how we are getting, why we can extend up to only 64 kilobytes of memory means, so that it depends purely upon the number of address lines. Number of address lines. Depending upon the address lines, based on that we will get the memory. Depending upon how many address lines are there, based on that we will get the memory. If for example 8051 is having 16 address lines. So how do we represent memory means, we represent the memory in powers of 2. We represent the memory in powers of 2. So 2 power 16, it is 64536 or 65536, or round off we call it as 64 kilobytes of memory. Okay. 64 kilobytes of memory means each memory location is byte oriented. Each memory location is byte oriented. So 4 zeros to 4s. 4 zeros to 4s. This is the 65536 slot. So total 65536 slots will be there. So in each slot we can store 8 bit of data. In each slot we can store the 8 bit of data. So here 8 bit, here 8 bit, here 8 bit, here 8 bit, like this we can store the 8 bit of data. So like for example, if we take one bench means, in one bench we can sit maximum 3 numbers means. So like that here in one bench, this is a one bench where we can sit 8 members. Here 8 members, 8 members, 8 members, like that. So how many slots will be there means, total 65536 slots will be there. So that is initial value is 4 zeros and final value is 4s. Okay. So this memory is purely depending upon the number of address lines. If address lines are more bits, for example 8086 address lines are 20 address lines. So we are getting 1 megabyte of memory. So based on these address lines only. So for example in cell phone, they are telling for 8 GB of memory. We can extend up to 8 GB of memory means. Why we are not able to extend more than that 8 GB of memory means? So we will write 5 8 means 2 power 3, G means 2 power 30. So 33 address lines are there. So that's why we are able to address 8 GB of memory. More than that 8 GB of memory we cannot address. Why? Because there are no memory slots. There are no frequent vacant memory slots where we can insert our data. So for example, in a class we can fit only 60 benches means maximum we can fit 60 benches. So more than that we cannot fit means there is no space. So similarly here also same thing. So in each memory location we can fit 8 bit of data. So these are the number of benches. Only these benches we can fit in that memory location. So that it purely depends upon the number of address lines that here is. Okay. So the memory that we can extend in 8051 is total 64 kilobytes of memory we can extend. So this RAM memory, this 128 bytes of RAM memory is made it into 3 parts. 128 bytes of RAM memory is made it into 3 parts. So that is, so from 00 to 07 and 08 to 0F and 10 to 17 and 18 to 1. So these are made into bank 0, bank 1, bank 2 and bank 3. Then from 20 to 2F, it is a bit addressable area, and from 30 to 7F, this is scratch pad memory. So general purpose memory. So 7F means 128. So like that 00 to 128 slots are there. 00 to 128 slots are there. So this is the memory address 00, 01, 02, 03, 04, 05, 06, 07. 8, 9, 10 like that, unique addresses. So in each address, it will be having, in each bank we are having, different registers R0 to R7, R0 to R7, R0 to R7, R0 to R7, R0 to R7. So total, if you take in 8051, there are 34 general purpose registers are there. 34 general purpose registers are there. Here 8 4s are 32. So this 32, R0 to R7 and A and B registers. So total 34 general purpose registers are there. R0 to R7, R0 to R7, R0 to R7. So how do we differentiate this R0 with this R0? How do we differentiate this R0 with this R0 means? We can tell it as bank 0 R0 or bank 1 R0 or bank 2 R0 and bank 3 R0. We can differentiate like that. So for example, if you take a classroom, for example, this is ECE, CSE and mechanical and triple E. So for example, if principal sir is calling a particular student, for example, R0. So how do he call the person R0 means? Either he will call by using, go to ECE and call R0. So in ECE only R0 will be there. So like that, in CSE only R0 will be there. Or otherwise, we can give the, by using different name, by using the address, or with the help of student means, by using the roll number. So roll number means there is no need to select any branch and everything. So each branch will be having different roll numbers. So this address is unique address. I can call 00 means R0 will come. 00 means R0 will come. So 08 means, bank 1 R0 will come. 10 means bank 2 R0 will come. 18 means bank 3 R0 will come. So like that we can differentiate by using the address or by selecting the bank and selecting the register. So instead of giving 32 different names, the processor, the controller, what they have done is they are given with only 8 names, easy to remember, R0 to R7, R0 to R7. And they have given 4 banks. In each bank, 8 registers will be there. So each register R0 is 8 bit. R0 to R7. So each register is of 8 bit size. We can store only 8 bit of data. So like that R0 to R7, R0 to R7. So whenever, so the default bank here is, bank 1. So for example, if I am writing move R0, 01 value means the processor will directly come here and he will store the value 01 here. So how he is storing means already we have seen the default bank that is starting is 01, bank 1. Okay, so move R0 comma 01 means the value will be stored here only. So if you want to change to any bank, there are flag register is there. So program status word is there. We can store in any of the register. Either we can store in bank 0 or bank 2 or bank 3, wherever we want we can store. So as already said, like whenever we are writing with register, generally we will select the bank, and then store the value. Or else we can write direct like this also. Move 08 comma hash 0. Both are safe. This is by selecting the roll number This is by selecting the register name. By calling the with name, this is by selecting the address. Both are same. Okay. So like this we can store the values in various memory location in 8051. Okay. Then we are having, so as I said, 8051 RAM memory is made it into three parts. So first part we have seen. So first part is, so total 32 bytes are reserved for register banks. Then next 16 bytes are reserved for bit addressable area. 16 bytes are reserved for bit addressable area. So here, if you take 20 to 27, total 16 bytes. So this is byte memory location. Inside it will be having bit memory location. This address is 00, 01, 02, 03, 04, 05, 06, 07. Then this is 08, 09, 10, 08, 0B like it. Okay. So what is the advantage of this bit addressable area means? Instead of, for example, I need to store a value. For example, I need to store a value 01. This means this is the value that I am storing. Only one bit of memory location I am storing. So instead of wasting all 7 bit memory location, say for example, we are having a status where my status will be either on status or off status. In 8086, if we are using this one, means entire memory location we have to store the value. But whereas in 8051, we can store that only single bit status in one memory location. So like that, 16 bytes of data, we are having 128 bit memory locations. In 16 byte data, we are having internally 128 bit location. For example, if you take hotel room, so 202 second floor means inside it will be having 8 rooms. So 201, 202, 203, 204, 205, 206, 207 like that. So like that we can have different 8 bit memory locations, So that is the 202F. So whenever if I am writing a instruction like this, move 20,01 means it is a byte memory location. I am storing in this memory location, this is the value I am storing. For example, if I write set B01 means I am not at all storing any memory location. Only in this memory location I am storing the value as 1. Anyway, we store in memory either 1 or 0. So this will become 1. So same thing. So that is the advantage of a bit addressable area where we can save the memory. So then remaining 30 bytes are reserved for general purpose memory. Where I can store any value in this memory location from 30 to 307. So if I write something value 3, move 30 comma hash 01 means, then the processor will come here and he will store the value 01. So 01 means 00000001. Since this is hexadecimal number, one hexadecimal number is equal to 4 binary numbers. So 4 binary numbers for 0 is this one. So 1 is 0001. So this 8 bit value will be stored in the memory location. So this is a byte memory location and these are all bits that are stored in this. So like this, 8051 is having internal RAM memory of 128, where first 4 bytes are reserved for register banks, bank 0, bank 1, bank 2 and bank 3. Remaining 16 bytes are reserved for bit addressable area and 30 bytes are reserved for general purpose memory. So the total memory is 128 bytes of memory. 128 bytes of memory.